Proud supporters of Africa this week. Engine. With us, you are number one.
Hello and welcome to this special live edition of Africa This Week. I'm Godfrey Mutizwa. I'm standing in for young Mashudu Masuta. Now, here today on the 11th of November in 2011, Zambia has released its budget. And as expected, that budget appears to be pro-poor in keeping with the election promises of new President Michael Sata. Remember, he unseated Rupiah Banda with promises to lower taxes and spread more widely the benefits of economic growth that has been spurred by higher copper prices. We'll be crossing to Isaac Ngoma, President of the Economics Association of Zambia, as well as Perry James Perone, IMF Senior Resident Representative to Zambia. Here in studio, I will be joined by Yvonne Mhango. She is sub-Sahara Economics at Renaissance Capital. A very good evening, Yvonne, and welcome to the program. As I said, it's 11th of November in 2011, 11, 11, 11, 11, and on this very day, Zambia has decided to unveil a budget that I have seen a various news agency reports suggest is a pro-poor budget and is also expensive. I've added in the word expensive, and I've also added there's a lot of expenditure in here. Let me get your initial impressions. Are you scared? Are you happy? What's your opinion?
Okay, are we especially concerned or alarmed? No. We did expect an expansionary budget, maybe not as expansionary as this one came out to be. They're projecting expenditure of 26.5% of GDP next year, higher than the 25% that the market was expecting, and up from 21% from this year. So yeah, they really are stepping up on expenditure. In terms of what items they're picking up expenditure on, it's health as well as education. The health sector is going to get a boost of around 45% of expenditure, education around 38%, as expected, particularly from his first speech to Parliament about a month ago. So in that regard, it's meeting his election promise, which is to be more inward looking and to address the poor.
Okay, so let's look at the headline numbers. The budget deficit for 2012 is being projected at 4.3% of GDP, and that's up from 3.5% of GDP.
Correct.
Our initial conversation was that you're not too alarmed by the increase in that budget deficit. So you agree that he's put in place proposal to fund that budget deficit that don't worry you too much in addition to widening it.
Well, they mostly expect to finance that budget, I think about two-thirds to three-quarters of it with domestic borrowing.
Right.
And then the remainder will be a combination of external financing as well as grants. I think grants will come up in about to less than 2% of GDP. They're also planning to issue that sovereign bond that the previous administration had started talking about. It's $500 million bond next year, so that should supplement their expenditure plans.
Right.
So for now, given where they're coming from, given that their public debt is around 21% of GDP, there is room for them to borrow more and to implement this expansionary budget.
Is there room to kill the cash cow? They are doubling the mining royalties taxes from 3% to 6%. Not quite clear whether that's on revenue or on profit. Perhaps we can get that update from Isaac Ngoma in Zambia when we cross to him. Mm-hmm. But just the mere doubling of that tax on its own, are you comfortable with that increase?
Of course, the miners will be unhappy about it. I mean, it's an increase from 3 to 6%. And just to take you 4 years back, remember we're coming from 0.5% mineral royalty tax. So that's quite a substantial increase in a period of 4 years. So yes, I'm sure the mining companies will not be particularly happy about that measure. But then again, it's not entirely a surprise that they have made some mining tax reforms or changes in the measures. That was expected, given his election promises or campaign promises.
Right.
So in terms of the impact on the mining sector, the impression is they were aware that there will be tax reforms. Whether or not they're happy with this particular measure, we're yet to hear.
It's another story. I'm seeing headlines suggesting that the miners are going to go ballistic, but we'll come back and have that conversation. Let's cross over now to Zambia, where we are joined by Isaac Ngoma. He is president of the Economics Association of Zambia. Isaac, a very good evening to you.
Good evening, thank you.
Did you expect the doubling in those mining royalties from 3% to 6%?
Well, I wouldn't say that you didn't expect that. It was something that was possibly going to be looked at because the challenge that the government had was whether they should reimpose the windfall tax or not.
Mm.
Now, in the absence of the windfall tax, which everyone has been calling for, they've had to settle for the mineral royalty tax increase. which has moved from 3% to 6%.
Yeah, but it's the quantum of it that we're talking about, isn't it?
Yeah, the quantum is what is significant there. That's like a hundredfold.
Yeah.
But then we must understand that there is this perception, widely held perception, that Zambia is not getting as much from its mineral resources as it's supposed to. Mm. So they're trying to at least increase their revenue from the mining sector to supplement their efforts towards the implementing most of the infrastructure development projects that they envisage to implement in this coming fiscal year.
Yeah. Can you give us a sense of what the reaction has been to the budget since Minister Alexander Chikwanda announced it in Parliament?
So far, from the little that I've got, having been bound to the presentation itself, it's a mixed reaction. If you talk to the ordinary people in the streets, maybe the expectations were so high, knowing the background where the new government of President Sata is coming from. People were looking forward to having the windfall tax reimposed. They were looking for many other drastic or radical, pronouncements in the budget. But it's been moderate and towing the line of their predecessors. Mm. And notable among these things, the balanced tax impositions that have come through.
Yeah.
There's been some relief for the, for the workers, in the sense that the amount for pay-as-you-earn has been doubled as well.
Right.
So the reaction is coming from two sectors. Those that are in gainful employment, they feel that they have a little bit more, onto them now as the PF coin, the coin slogan, more money in their pockets.
Yeah.
Whereas those that are not, maybe their expectations have been dashed because they're expecting much more, which has not come.
Yeah.
But as far as mining is concerned, I think there has to be a balanced act. I know that government has been in the mining sector to try and find common ground, which would be more like a win-win situation.
Did you get any sense of the reaction in Parliament, though? What was what did MPs think of the new budget?
In fact, from the two opposing sides, the major opposition parties, that is the former party that was in government,
the MMB.
Yeah, the reaction has been positive. They see it as a pro-poor growth directed budget. So they don't really have issues with it per se. But for the PF, it's their first budget, and there have been indications that they didn't have much time to, undo the budget, which was almost complete by the time that they were coming into power. They didn't have sufficient time to undo it and align it, according to what they would have wanted to do. But they've tried to direct it by ensuring that there's some level of continuity for now and look up to something else in the coming year.
Isaac, before we let you go, were there any specific areas that you were unhappy about or that you particularly happy about that came out in the budget?
First and foremost, looking at the specific macroeconomic targets set for 2012, those I think are okay. They are achievable and they are majorly in line with what we've had in the recent past. We've towed the line of consistent growth. So the targets set are welcome and they're very good. And most of the things that are being pronounced in the areas of strategic interventions are okay, but there was need to put in much more emphasis on the specifics, setting the milestones and the targets, and also answering the questions on the how, because the detail is always in the implementation.
Mm.
The pronouncements are one thing, but where we have failed as a country, looking at where we're coming from in the past, is the implementation. So we would like to see a more organized and systematic way of implementing most of the policies and programs that government proposes to implement come 2012.
Yeah.
But on the downside also, maybe some of the things that I would talk about would be looking at the social sector, as much could have been done, but I'm also mindful that we are limited in terms of the resources available. Also issues pertaining to citizens' economic empowerment. I think these need to be supplemented further by other, you know, non-budget or off, you know, balance sheet measures as well, so that we can see an accelerated approach towards citizens' economic empowerment.
Yeah. Yvonne, Isaac raises a number of issues there, and one of the issues he raises is around the ability of the government to implement it. Mm-hmm. Now, we of course remember us in the media that this is the same president who fired the governor of the central bank upon assuming office, a central bank governor who had been liked very much by the market for his steady as she goes type of management, and of course the previous finance minister is now gone. Are you worried on the implementation side? Do we have the capacity within Zambia to see this budget through, implemented as planned?
I think the brief answer is no, I don't think we have the full capacity to fully implement a budget, but that's no fault of the particular administration. I just think it's the nature or shortcomings of our administrations or governments generally
in sub-Saharan Africa.
Yes, the big test is delivery. There have been lots of promises made, a lot of them to the poor Zambians. We've seen huge allocations, as I mentioned earlier, go towards health and education. The actual question is whether we are going to see the delivery of those services.
Yeah.
And that will be the test of this administration going forward.
Yeah. I'm reminded here of Zimbabwe in 1980. Robert Mugabe comes into power, and what does he do? He gives a big focus onto education, onto health, and he really transformed that economy because of the focus in that area. But he had a very capable, if you like, infrastructure that had been left by the previous regime. Now here, we've got Sata coming in and increasing resources onto health, 45%, 27% for education, and 38% for a boost in mining subsidies. There are broad similarities here. But the big question has to be the sustainability of these actions that he has taken. Are you comfortable on that front?
Firstly, let's look at the direction of which he's taken.
Yeah. If
the fact that he's pointed out or focused his resources on health and education, excuse me, implies that human capital is what's important to him.
Sure.
So basically enhancing or improving the quality of that. And that's, of course, the favor to the poor.
Sure.
We do have, aside from the leadership, let's put it that way, in government that's been removed, the people on the ground, the teachers and the health workers are still in place.
Yeah.
Maybe the challenge was that they didn't have sufficient resources in which to deliver.
Right.
And maybe this
resources are now coming.
Resources will help them in terms of delivery. So in terms of the sustainability, that all depends on whether they have the resources going forward,
right,
which brings us back to the financing capability.
Right.
For now, yes, for the medium term, we do think they will be able to sustain that. However, the challenge is ensuring that the economy is growing fast enough in order to sustain the rising debt levels.
And that is going to be a big question mark, because I suppose if these figures are to be believed, we have to assume that the mining sector will continue growing at the same pace that it's been growing, if not better.